a big guest on today's episode of The Crowded Booth as we welcome in South Carolina head coach Shane Beamer. Coach Beamer talks about the change in college football, where the sport's going, and most importantly, how does South Carolina fit into the new picture? All that and more, and this interview with Shane Beamer. All right, we're back here inside the booth with head coach Shane Beamer of the South Carolina Gamecocks. Coach, amidst everything going on, I know there's truly no offseason. We appreciate you taking the time to come on and talk to us today.
Absolutely. I appreciate you inviting me.
Well, let's kind of start here. I mean, look, obviously, you know, it's a couple years into this thing for you. I mean, I remember you getting hired and all the excitement around the South Carolina fan base. What have you learned about yourself through the first couple years over there in Columbia and just maybe about yourself and about this program as this sport continues to change?
Yeah, it's been fantastic. 3 years, we've by no means are we satisfied. Last season record-wise wasn't what we wanted, but feel like we've accomplished a lot. And we've accomplished a lot of firsts here at Carolina in 3 years. And some things that were the first time ever here at Carolina with our football program, and a lot of things that it was the first time in over 10 years that we had, you know, done something, whether it be beating Kentucky on the road or beating Texas A&M or Clemson up at Clemson a couple years ago. So what I've learned is, you know, one, you better continue to surround yourself with great people, which I feel like we have with our players, coaches, staff. So everyone is very much aligned in our building right now. And then I think every year you learn something. Every day I learn something. You know, nowadays in college athletics, all of us as head coaches, whether you're myself or someone that's been doing it for 30 years, every day things are changing. And we as coaches, we're all going through stuff for the very first time in a lot of ways in regards to NIL, transfer portal, et cetera, and just kind of trying to learn and not make the same mistake twice.
You talk about learning. Obviously, Coach, you amongst your peers, you guys are process-oriented people. I've talked to enough coaches to kind of understand that. Obviously, this is a results-based business. But, you know, kind of that microwave effect, what have you done for me recently? You mentioned last year, not the year that you guys wanted. How has it been this offseason to kind of maybe take a step back and understand, hey, this process is the same one, although it didn't get us the results we wanted last year, it's the same one that allowed us to do some of those first and to really kind of build excitement back into this program?
Yeah, no, great point. You always, every single year, you look at how we can be better the next year. And we did that after our first season here when we won 7 games and won our bowl game. We did it after year two when we won 8 games and finished with wins over Tennessee and Clemson. And then we said, okay, going into 2023, how are we going to be better? And we didn't do a good enough job of it. And you look at everything at the end of the season like we did, big picture wise, how can we improve? And that's in every area, weight room, training room. You know, we had a lot of injuries last season. We had 12 season-ending injuries, 6 on the offensive line. So you look at why those injuries happened. And it's the same training staff that we had when we won 7 games and 8 games the 2 years previous. It's the same strength and conditioning program. So let's look at how do we be better, because we weren't good enough, coaches-wise, everything. But also understanding big picture, no, record-wise, we weren't where we wanted to be. Nobody's patting ourselves on the back for moral victories, but we weren't sitting there 0-12. You know, we had a chance to win every game and we just couldn't finish some games. We weren't able to get over the hump in some games, and we had opportunities and we had a lot of self-inflicted errors. It starts with us as coaching. So as coaches, starting with me. So really it's just, looking at everything, understanding that it's a thin line between winning and losing in college athletics. It was a thin line in 2021 and 2022 when we had solid seasons. And same thing last year when the season didn't go the way we wanted record-wise. But everyone has come back with great hunger and desire, and everybody's going in the same direction right now and excited about where we are.
Obviously, this time of the year, it kind of feels like everyone's got a clean slate. You're starting to build some of that momentum heading into the summer, into the fall. Just some things that when you evaluate spring ball, look, a lot of people get excited about it. Us in the media, we like to pinpoint certain things. What are some characteristics or some traits that you want to see that when you get into the, you know, later month of April after that spring game, you can say, okay, this was a successful spring game? Or spring time.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. One, just the effort and you know, physicality that we want to play with, making sure that we're seeing that on tape. We've got a lot of new faces, just like a lot of teams do in college football. When you talk about new transfers or new freshmen that are here right now going through spring practice for the first time. So they're all learning what to do mentally, but they all can play with, it's not hard to teach the effort that we want to play with and the toughness and the physicality that we want to play with. So making sure that we see that on tape, you know, the decision-making, particularly at the quarterback position, obviously, playmaking ability, want to be able to walk out of spring practice and say, okay, it's pretty evident that these guys can be playmakers for us, and let's continue to figure out how to ways to utilize them. So I think there's a lot of it, but you also understand that you still have a lot of work to do, but you get 15 practices in the spring to really kind of lay that foundation of how we do things, how we practice, where there's an understanding with all of our new players, how we do things here at Carolina, that they will know, you know, going forward. So when we get into preseason camp, we're not teaching that over again.
You talked a little bit about this, and I mentioned in the beginning, just this schedule that, you know, we have during the off season right now. I know coaches across the country, we've done interviews with them and saying, you know, hey, we try to give our guys some downtime. How have you managed just where this schedule is and in the day-to-day grind of this sport? It's still going to be a grind no matter what. How have you managed that with your staff to make sure, hey, we're all on the same page, we're all in a good mental state to kind of keep this thing moving along?
Yeah, really just trying to, you know, build in some time in February. February's challenging. Well, really, you go back to January, used to when the season ended, you never really had a break, but you could have a little bit of a break as a college coach at the end of the season in January. You really can't now because of the transfer portal. You know, you're trying to get guys in school. Our season ends and you got about a week and a half, 2 weeks after the bowl games before school starts again. So you're trying to get guys here and you're recruiting. So you don't get much of a break right before when the season ends. And then you go right back into being on the road and recruiting in January. So I tried to this year, you know, give our guys some long weekends in February where they can get out of town and trying to align. We have a lot of coaches whose kids are obviously in elementary school or middle school, high school, whatever it might be. So trying to align if the kids have a winter break or a 3-day weekend in their school system, trying to give our coaches long weekends where they can get away, because certainly you want to have that balance without a doubt, and try and build those in just so our guys can, you know, because it is a grind and it's more of a grind than ever, but you also want to make sure that, you know, they're able to stay fresh physically and mentally as coaches. And then also, you know, there's an excitement about when they are in this building, there's not a dread about coming in here. They're excited about getting to work and having a chance to work with the young guys we have in our program.
Kind of parlays into the next part of this. I mean, I've talked with coaches in certain years where they feel like things could be special. They say, I've got the right guys in the building. And it's not just those guys, you know, the 85 scholarship guys and plus in the locker room. It's that staff. Obviously, you know, you've had some turnover with your staff and your tenure here so far. What's kind of the feeling? What's the temperature in these, you know, staff meeting rooms, in these position rooms, and where have you kind of gauged, hey, I feel like this is the right group to lead us where we want to go?
Yeah, it's, you know, obviously right now everything's good. We haven't faced a lot of adversity. We haven't played a game yet. Things are good right now, but I love this group that we have. After the season, yeah, we did have some turnover. We had two guys got head coaching positions, which is awesome for them that they got the opportunity to go be a head coach. One move I made where I made a decision to move on from someone, and then another one that, you know, I reassigned and decided that he didn't want to coach the position that I moved him to. But it led us to get, in my mind, four really, really fantastic coaches in our program here, in Markwell Blackwell coaching our running backs, Joe D. Camillus coaching our special teams, Mike Furry coaching our wide receivers, and then Sean Elliott coming back to coach the tight ends and be the run game coordinator. You're talking about two guys that have been head coaches, and Mike and Sean. You talk about a guy, Mike, that coached receivers in the NFL, plus he played receiver in the NFL. He's made an unbelievable impact with our receivers already. Sean Elliott has been an offensive line coach, has been a head coach. Markwell Blackwell has been an offensive coordinator at the college level. and has coached some of the best running backs around. And then Joe DeCamillis, a longtime NFL veteran that spent last season at Texas, that coached in four Super Bowls, I believe, in his time as an NFL coach. So, you know, their background, obviously, they're great guys, but just their professionalism and how they do things. They're real dudes. And I mean that as a compliment, just real dudes, professional. They all four of them have made our program better already. And really, really excited about what they've done, how they've contributed, and what they will continue to do as well.
Last one here for you, Coach. You know, look, a lot of the media hype is surrounding this new college football, this new SEC that you and all the other programs going to embark on this fall. Just kind of talk to me, when you've kind of been on the recruiting trail through the early portions of this year, and you've been able to have conversations with young men, what is the sentiment of this new SEC, this more competitive SEC, and how does that affect maybe positively or negatively how you sell South Carolina as a program? How have you seen that transpire?
Yeah, no, we talk about it all the time. One, just the power of the SEC and how impactful it is. And all you have to do when you talk to recruits is just show them the results of the NFL draft over the last close, I think it's 20 years or 19 years, where the SEC has led the country in draft picks for that many years in a row, which is amazing when you really think about it as well. So you talk about that as a competitor, which we talk about all the time in recruiting, like let's get guys here that love to compete and love football. If you love to compete, there's no better conference in America than coming here and having a chance to compete with the best teams year in, year out. And then certainly these young men that we're recruiting, they're aware of what's going on, and they see, let me see how to put this. They see other colleges that are suing to get out of their conference to try and get into our conference as well. So it is what it is. And I know there's financial reasons and all that as well. But to me, the SEC has never been stronger. The power of the SEC has never been stronger. And, you know, young men that we're recruiting are very aware of that. And yeah, if you're a competitor, this is a great league for you. I mean, you look at the schedule and you go down through all 12 games, and there's not like a week where you say, we can take a breath there and that's a breather. There's no breathers in this league. And as a coach and as a player, like, I love that. And I want to surround myself with other people here in this program that have that same mentality, that we get to go play this schedule, not we have to.
Shane Beamer, South Carolina's head coach, getting ready for 2024. Coach, I do hope that you get to kind of take the family, get away for a little bit. Do you have a vacation planned at some point just to get away from it a little bit?
Yeah, we will. You know, I got three. My wife and I have three kids, 15, 13, and 10. So they stay pretty busy as well. And they're at the age where they still like hanging out with me and my wife. So they enjoy going on vacation and things like that. So I'm not sure what exactly we have planned, but it'll be somewhere this summer, hopefully warm and around the water without a doubt. But at the same time, I love what I do here and coaching at Carolina, and don't feel like this is work every day that I walk in this building either.
That's awesome. That's awesome. We appreciate you, Coach. Best of luck to you this season. Excited to see how this team and this program continues to thrive in 2024.
Thank you very much. Means a lot.
Well, we appreciate Coach Beamer's time and being able to sit down with us and discuss during the midst of a crazy college football calendar. And as you heard, there are big expectations for Beamer and the South Carolina Gamecocks as they head into a pivotal year in the SEC. For more content like this, head over to our YouTube page, click that subscribe button, like this video, and comment what you think down below. What are the expectations for South Carolina here in 2024 and beyond? This is The Crowded Booth. My name is Bryce Koon, and we'll catch you next time.